attention, please. It's time for the final countdown. The show starts in
10. You have a dream?
9.
And if you have a goal?
8.
I want you to go after it.
7.
It doesn't matter your age.
6.
And it doesn't matter your race.
5.
You can make it.
4.
I promise.
3.
So go.
2.
Be defiant.
1.
And live your dream. Unafraid. Defy all odds.
I am defiant. There is nothing that can hold back my greatness.
I am defiant.
And the same goes for you. Welcome to the Defiant Ones Team Podcast, hosted by Kindify. The show starts now.
Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of the Defiant Ones Team Podcast. If you are new here, welcome. I am Christian Kindify Robinson, and to tell you guys a little bit about this show, we just had a major show with Les Brown, an exclusive interview, so if you are new, I would definitely recommend you go and check that out. But the Defiant Ones Team Podcast is a podcast made from or stemmed from the Defiant Ones Teen Magazine, which is a magazine for teens by teens created by me and my brother just a year ago. It has been a year in the making, and we are so appreciative of the support that we've been getting and all the room that we've grown. I know that we still have so much farther to go, and we want to make an impact. So in the magazine, we talk about the latest fashion, news, sports, trends, things that schools aren't teaching us as youth that we need to learn if we want to grow and thrive and succeed and excel in life. That's what we're covering. And what makes us different is it's coming from a youth's perspective. So there are only so much that society says that you can do as a person when it comes to your age, your race, your gender, etc. We want to take that and say, that's not true. Who gets to say who we can be? Who gets to limit our potential? Because it's not them. We set our life. We create our goal. We create our dream. We create our story. So we're going to defy. We are going to defy the odds. We are going to push past the limitations and expectations that life and even sometimes ourselves put upon ourselves. We are going to go after our dreams and make it. We are going to thrive and excel and be successful and be happy. We are going to be defiant. So that's what this magazine is and what we stand for. This podcast basically takes those stories and just gives it to you straight up. We learn people's stories, their successes, failures, everything they've accumulated in their life to give it to you straight, to help you garner their knowledge and expertise, to help you grow and thrive, because that's what we want. We want everyone to excel and succeed. So welcome. We are so glad to have you here. We have an amazing guest here with us today. I'll tell you, I am a big fan of making your own things, making your own story, making your own dreams. And we have someone who has made her story and made her legacy and made her name known throughout the world. This is the amazing YouTuber, DIY creator, and social media influencer, and also musician, Jennifer Zhang, also known as Gen Z. You guys help me give a warm welcome to Gen Z. Hey! There we go.
Hey! Technology issues.
Yeah. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. Fantastic. So can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, so my name is Jennifer, and I go by Gen Z for all my music stuff, and I am currently a full-time YouTuber and also artist, and yeah, I think that's my little spiel.
Yeah, where are you from, Jen?
I'm from Vancouver in Canada, and that's where I am right now, so it's getting cold, but yeah, got my sweaters on. Got my heaters on. It's getting cozy.
It is getting very cold. I will tell you that. You know, I've never been to Canada. What's it like down there?
I think it's really nice. Lots of nature, if you're into that. And it's just like, I like different parts of Canada versus the US. Like, it's really, it's more like slow and like peaceful here, and I get to be with my family. But I love going to LA for like work and the entertainment industry and that kind of stuff. So I feel like I'm living the Hannah Montana life, like the worlds.
Both worlds.
Yeah.
Fantastic. So I want to start with your story of DIYing. If you guys don't know what DIYing is, it's basically taking something that is the norm and creating something or that thing of your own. So can you explain to us, you probably can do it better than I can, just exactly what DIYing or creating your own things are and what you first made or why?
Yeah, so DIYing to me is like using what you have and making the most of it and doing everything yourself. So I first started my YouTube channel 7 years ago when I was 15. And I just really was into like crafting and like making these projects. And so one day I just filmed something and just, I really love the creation process, like filming and editing and teaching myself how to do that. And luckily I've been able to build a career out of my hobby. And now I'm actually kind of going back to my roots because my first channel was actually a singing channel, but it was like super embarrassing and like it's completely private from the internet and like nobody can access it now. Yeah, so at the time I'm still very much like an introverted kind of shy person, but I was a lot more like like not very confident in myself. And so I wasn't ready to like sing in front of people. And now I feel like over these 7 years, I've built up my confidence and now I'm ready to like share my music with the world. And so, yeah, my music career is also very much DIY. Like this last song that I put out, I recorded just with my voiceover mic for my YouTube videos in my bedroom with a bunch of like blankets and pillows to like absorb sound because I like couldn't go to school. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, and I feel like the pandemic really showed me and a lot of people that you can do a lot of things yourself. And I think a lot of people have started businesses and like started different careers and hobbies out of just like not being able to access normal things. And I feel like that aspect has been really like a blessing. Of course, the pandemic in general is like terrible, but I think a lot of people have been able to like squeeze little like cool things out of it.
Yeah, this pandemic, I mean, it's given us its good and it's also given us its bad. It's given us its bad primarily when you're looking at the news and you're looking at the rates of people who are getting sick and affected, but it's also giving us opportunity. It's giving us time, which we've never had before. Now we have, for the first time ever, the availability of time to create our businesses, to create our dreams, to grow ourselves and to branch out into the things that we want to do in life. So I absolutely do see where you're coming from. And in the creating process, how do you learn or how do you come up with ideas? And what would you say is like the best thing that you've made?
I feel like for my videos, I usually just look at things that I would buy and I'm like, okay, I'm not going to pay $100 for a pillow, and I would just like make it myself. Yeah. My music, I feel like everyone just takes inspiration from their own lives. But for me, I mean, lately life has just been kind of boring and stagnant. So sometimes I'll just like create stories, and I feel like songwriting is just like one of the only ways for me to like communicate my feelings, because I'm not really great with like communication in words, just like speaking, I guess. Yeah. And in songs and lyrics, it's more like carefully crafted and I can like think on it. And yeah, this previous song that I put out, Falling to Your Knees, was actually inspired. Well, I wrote it in response to like a little bit of like racism back when COVID was just starting out and it was like the peak of the pandemic. Yeah. And I never had to really deal with it to that extent or like that explicitly before. So it was just kind of like a little bit frustrating to kind of have to deal with some of those comments. And I was like arguing with some people in the comments, and eventually I was like, okay, I gotta stop this. And so I wrote this song. And yeah, it's just like, I feel like it was also an accumulation of a lot of thoughts I've had over the years about this and just like growing up. So yeah, long story.
No, I get it. And actually, I've listened to the song. It is incredible. So I would like, so just a preview. Here we go.
Dancing to your beat, wanting to blend in, no self-expression, 'cause I wanted you to see I'm not so different, fit in your system, so why do you tell me I'm wrong when I say the same things that you say, and you double the standards because you only like your.
Which makes me only wonder how long ago you started. When did you start singing?
So I've never had like any formal singing training.
Yeah.
And I'm kind of just like winging it and doing it for fun. I guess I would say like 3-4 years ago, like seriously, that's when I put out my first single, I think 3 years ago. But what was that?
What was your first single called?
It was called By the Rules. I mean, it's still up, but it's like, it's been so long. So I'm like, let's focus on the new stuff I put out. Yeah. But I feel like we always have to like start somewhere. And like, I'm proud of that song. I'm proud of that song because I am proud of myself for like putting that out and like putting myself outside of box and just like trying to reach outside of my comfort zone. And I think I've gotten a lot better at songwriting and like creating music. So hopefully people can hear that.
Oh, absolutely. And I love the concept and the message of self-confidence. That was literally fantastic. What message would you say in the norm of your music do you try to portray? What message do you try to bring to the audience?
I think for me, I want people to feel empowered and just can find some sort of relatability in my songs, because I write everything from like kind of obstacles that I've had in my life. And a lot of my songs are very like, kind of like angry or like sad, but like danceable music. So I hope it's like they get some sort of empowerment and confidence, but also are able to like have some good quality like bop sessions in their room.
Yeah. Who would you say your biggest musical influence is?
Definitely I love Dua Lipa right now. I'm like her number one fan and I can't wait to see her in concert in real life. And I love Sigrid, of course, Ariana, the pop queens. I very much like I just love pop music. Mm-hmm. And I grew up listening to just like the radio hits, you know, like Avril Lavigne. And I feel like I'm really getting into the 2000s, like pop punk lately, a lot of like MGK. Yeah. And Miley, just like, I listen to a bunch of different people, but I love pop.
Yeah. It's great to be diverse. And I'll tell you right now, Jen, as soon as the world opens right up, I'm going to fly out to Canada. We're going to every concert. I already convinced
myself. Number one on the list.
I'm trying to tell you, Ariana Grande, Bruno Mars, all of their concert going to, because you know they're going to, the tickets are going to be kind of, you know.
Yeah, they're going to be gone in like 5 seconds.
That's absolutely going to happen. I can't wait. So do you remember your first time performing or has the coronavirus kind of taken the opportunity away from you?
Yeah, I actually haven't performed live ever. I mean, I've done like school choirs before, but I've never performed my songs live before. I've just been doing some IG live sessions. So I haven't had that opportunity yet, but I'm really excited to possibly do one next year, but like also who knows at this point.
Yeah.
Just waiting and hoping.
Yeah, I understand that. Corona has taken, again, so much away from us. But, I mean, even without that, it's hard coming up in the industry. It is. I'll tell you right now, starting this magazine, I mean, it's a lot of pressure when you want to go after your dreams and when you have to take that leap of faith. It takes a lot in you. So what other things or what other struggles would you say you faced coming up to become where you are right now? And how did you overcome?
I think for me, just like starting from when I was 15, I was just young and like, I didn't really know anything. And so I've had to just learn everything myself from like making YouTube videos, like teaching myself how to film and edit. And like, I'm sure you can relate, trying to figure out like equipment and like filming and recording and all that kind of stuff. But I feel like it's always also been a really fun challenge, because for me, I really like to try to figure out how to do these like creative things and like put my own spin on things. And it's just really satisfying when you figure something out. I think something like problems with the pandemic, being in isolation, like being by yourself, have also kind of been some of my issues beforehand, because I like work by myself for myself. Yeah. And so it gets kind of lonely sometimes just trying to like do everything myself. And so I feel like in this pandemic, we've all kind of like gone through the same struggle. So in a way it does, it's like we're all kind of like in it together. Yeah.
Yeah, but you know what? You came out on the other side. You came out successful. And you came out, like you said, creative. You know, I have to commend you for learning to film and edit the way that you do, because you're incredible at it. And I'm actually still trying to learn. I'm trying to become a motivational speaker, author, graphic designer, and a whole bunch more. Anything I can do for myself, if I want to start a business, I want to learn. That's just the dream I have. To be successful, I want to learn how to do all the things that is necessary for going after it. So I want to show a clip of just how amazing you are and just how crafted you are when it comes to the creative side of you, editing and all.
Shine on, diamond, don't make me wait another day. This passion, you know it just as well as me.
My gosh, I miss I that was from last year in December, and like it was such a different time, and I was traveling, but yeah.
That was beautiful.
Thank you.
That makes me just want to go visit Canada so much more.
Yeah, I haven't watched that in a while, and it just like gave me such good vibes.
Yeah, it's surreal. It's surreal, especially with all the effects and things you did with it. So you're extremely good. But
thank you.
People can see things like that, DIY videos, your music, and more. What else can they expect, or what can you say about your very successful YouTube channel?
Well, I'm always filming and editing new videos every week, and I'm working on an EP for the music side, but yeah, stay tuned for that, I guess, but always just like working on new content, so... Yeah.
Yeah. And can you give the people the name of the channel?
It's Generation DIY with a J, because my 15-year-old self really loved puns.
Well, I honestly want to ask you, because I'm very curious.
Mm-hmm.
Is there a inspiration or a type of thing behind the name Generation DIY?
I think I was just like brainstorming a bunch of different ideas that had Jen in it. And but I think over time it's really become this like multi like dimensional name, I guess. It's like Generation Z, which I and you are, and yeah. It's like the generation of DIYing, like doing things yourself, because I feel like kids nowadays are growing up and like realizing we can do a lot of things ourselves. And so it's just like a lot of different things that like encompass perfectly what I am and what I want to put out into the world. And so my artist name is Gen Z, which is also because my name is Jennifer Zhang, Gen Z. I didn't want to do Jay-Z because we already got one of those. But yeah, it's just like a bunch of puns, and I feel like I really like how it just like encompasses everything that I stand for.
Definitely. It's fun. It's super fun. But you know what? When I first read it, it made me think that, you know, this girl has gone after her dream. She's still young. You're very young and very successful still. But DIY obviously is creating. Your name is Jen.
Yeah.
And your YouTube is Generation. I said that you are a pillar for the next generation of creators. I said that you are inspiring the next generation of creators, of DIY creations. So that's how I look at it. I think that you're inspiration.
Thank you. That's a really good take. Yeah, and I hope that people watching my videos will feel inspired to do things themselves and be themselves and know that like you can do a lot more than you think you can. And I think I've learned that definitely through the years. So I feel like if I can do it, anyone can do it.
Yeah. Nothing is limitless. Nothing is limitless to those who define. I believe that you're defying. You are defying the odds.
Thank you.
And I think we're going to continue to. So let me ask, what is your dream in life? What do you want to do? Who do you want to be?
Ooh, that's a big question. I feel like I'm still trying to figure out. And I think we, as young people, always have a lot of pressure on us to figure out things really quick, like when we're graduating or like, I don't know, like going to university or like trying to, or when they ask like, what do you want to be in 5-10 years?
Yeah.
And we always have like an answer, but it's, you know, you never really know what's going to happen. And especially I feel like nowadays it's like, who really knows?
Yeah.
I really want to still be making music because that's what really makes me happy. And, possibly making YouTube videos if people still want to watch.
Yeah.
I just want to be happy in whatever I'm doing, and I hope that continues.
That's exactly what it takes. If you're happy, people should support you, because I mean, obviously you're amazing at what you do. But I love a point that you said in there. You said that we as youth feel pressured when we're asked what we want to do in life. The example you gave, college. I'm a firm believer, and I know this goes against some people's beliefs, that you don't always have to have a plan and an exact set goal in life. If you know who you want to be, if you want to be an influencer, if you want to be just someone who makes an impact, someone who can make people smile and laugh and be happy in yourself, then that's all you need. If you have the dream, if you have the goal, if you have the desire to be successful or to make a name for yourself, you will. I don't think you have to have an exact plan as long as you believe, because that is affirmation. You are bringing it into the atmosphere.
You are pulling. Yeah, exactly. And I like to add on to the university point, I actually had this like very like detailed plan. I was going to go to university, graduate, and then like get some job or like do YouTube. I went to university, dropped out after 2 years, and now I'm doing YouTube full time. So it's, the plan has really gone down the drain, but I think I'm doing fine. So
you're doing very good. Did you hear that you had to, was it your decision to drop out? because
because I was trying to balance too much, I think, just doing full-time school and also doing full-time YouTube and then like trying to also do music stuff. It was just a lot. And I think I really wanted to take advantage of social media, and I was just like kind of like on the up and rising with YouTube, and I was like, I just want to make sure that I don't lose this opportunity. And of course, I think education is super important, but I like my priority at the time was like my career, and I'm still like learning in different ways. It's not necessarily like through textbooks and stuff in school, but yeah. I think everyone should do what is best for them. And sometimes that's going to school, sometimes that's not. And I think it's just important for people to know that there's different paths to success and being happy. Yeah.
Most definitely. Most definitely. And there's an amazing quote that we did an interview with the fantastic motivational speaker, Les Brown. If you go back on our page, Defiant Ones Mag on YouTube or Facebook, you can check it out. But he has an amazing quote that says, "You're never too old to learn and you're never too young to teach." You said that you're still learning, but I think that you can teach people of all ages. I think that you can teach us how to go after our dreams and how to be successful. So let me ask you a question, and we'll start to close out here. What would you say to inspire someone out there who wants to go after their dreams and who wants to be a creator, but not just any ordinary creator, but a creator of their own destiny?
Ooh, that's a good question. I think this is really cliche, but you have to be authentic to yourself and stay true to yourself. I think for me, creating YouTube videos and just like social media content in general, it's really important for you to like connect with your audience and for them to know that you're a real person. And I think that's true for a lot of jobs and a lot of sectors in like the entertainment industry in general, because people just want to be able to connect with someone and know that they're not alone in how they feel or how they think. And I think especially nowadays, people just want to feel like they have a friend, whether it's like in real life or watching someone through the screen. And I think that staying true to yourself really can take you far.
It can. It can. And that was beautifully said. Beautifully said and beautifully portrayed. You are living the life of a defiant one. So how can people, this is kind of the chance to plug yourself. I saw one of your videos. You're like, I don't want to plug myself. But how can people find, contact, and book you?
Shameless self promo. You can find me at Generation DIY on all social media platforms and Gen Z for all music.
Fantastic. Fantastic. Thank you so much, Jen. You are a gem. We really, really appreciate you. And I want you to do something, because I want you to say it loud and proud. I believe that you are living the lifestyle and that you are defiant. So can you say who you are, what you do, and I am defiant?
Yeah, I am Jennifer. And I am a musician and YouTuber, and I am defiant.
Yes, you are. Thank you so, so much, Gen Z, Jennifer Zhang. We so, so appreciate you coming on here to the show, and we will definitely be catching up with you later. Have a
fantastic
day.
Thank you so much for having me.
Don't freeze your butt off. I know it's so cold.
Yeah.
Bundle up.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Guys. She is a gem. She is a gem. Jen is a gem. If you like the stories that you're hearing, if you like the people that we're sharing, and you like the knowledge and experience and expertise that we are giving out, please subscribe to the Defiant Ones Teen Magazine and podcast. We are on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter at Defiant Ones Mag. That is at Defiant Ones Mag. You can go to our website to learn more about us if you want to become an advertiser, sponsor, get your magazine, or learn about our team, anything like that. You can go to our website, defiantonesmag.com. DefiantOnesMag.com. We have so much more in store for you all. I mean, again, everything is limitless. Your dreams are limitless. If you believe in yourself and you don't take what you hear from society that doubts you or that says you can't do something, I promise you can. I promise you can. And we want to be an example of that. We want to get our magazine and our voices into the stores, airports, juvenile detention centers, and everywhere so that we can inspire the youth. We are the youth. We are the youth. We want to inspire people like us. We want to inspire dreamers like us that they can go after their dreams, that it is possible. So if you want to support us and really hope that you do, please, again, follow us on all social media at Defiant Ones Mag. You can go to our website, DefiantOnesMag.com, to do everything listed before. And you can find me, your host, Christian Kindify Robinson, on Instagram and Facebook, at Kindify. I so appreciate you guys coming on here. It is about to be Christmas. It is about to be Christmas. We have so much planned in store for the holidays, and we hope that you all have a fantastic holiday. I do want to note that we just released our previous magazine with Brianna Harper, the incredible now 13-year-old musician and singer, on the cover. It is an absolutely fantastic magazine. If you hadn't had a chance to already check it out, definitely go to our website and get yours today. It is something that you will absolutely love and learn from. Once again, I thank you all so much for coming on, and we will see you in the next episode. Peace.